I'm practicing obstetrician and gynecologist at Nagpur since many 36 years at now. I must say that immunity is a word which is now in this pandemic era most commonly searched in internet, because everybody wants to boost the immunity. So in by definition wise, immunity is a system of the body that restricts the infection, or it can be said as a capability of immune body or multicellular organism to restrict harmful microorganism. Or if I make it in a simpler word, then it is ability to resist and not be infected by disease. Immune system has two group components. One is cells and another is protein. In cells, there are two kinds of cells, normal cell and specific cell. What are the normal cells? These are macrophages and natural killer cells. In special cells, we have T cells and B cells. Whenever any infection like virus or bacteria enters into the body, the natural killer cells kills that infection, which we call as a antigen. So what happens? The natural killer cells, they work throughout, day and the night, non-specifically. Whenever any bacteria, any virus comes, they kill it. And what macrophages does? It goes to that particular infection, they engulf the infection or antigen and kill it. Not only they kill it, but they also send a signal to the T cells, the specific cells, as I have told you, that there are T cells and B cells. So they not only kill the macrophages, but they send the signal to the T cell that some bacteria has entered in our body. Be ready. Then what T cells does, they send signal to B cells and they tell them, prepare some antibody. Then B cells starts preparing antibody against that particular virus or bacteria or antigen, what we call it. So this antibody will kill only that particular bacteria, only that particular virus. And what happens, not only they kill it, this antibody, but they make a picture of it and they keep it in a memory. So whenever the same infective material comes in our body, these antigen or that particular virus or bacteria get identified by the memory cell because they have taken the picture, and then they immediately start making the antibodies. First time the infection will be severe. It will take time for antibody to develop. But whenever second time the same infection will enter in our body, the antibodies will be formed very rapidly and this infection will not be that severe. Beside this, there are many cells like neutrophils, granulocytes, lymphocytes. They all work throughout day and night to prevent our body from getting infection. Even though we cannot get it, it takes years, months to develop your immunity. So if you ask me how to develop naturally, then I would say three components it has. Number one is nutrition, number two is lifestyle, and number three is supplement. So if we ask go for the nutrition, then it means you have to take all the good food, balanced diet with what we say. You have to add in your platter the fruits, vegetable, leafy vegetable, green leafy vegetables, then turmeric, ginger, garlic, citrus fruits, and then citrus syrup, honey. It is said that they boost the immunity. But yes, junk food you have to avoid. You have to avoid the spicy food. You have to avoid the fried food, deep fried food. They decrease your immunity. And if you ask me the another component, then supplements. If it is virus, then we have to take antiviral treatment. If it is bacteria, then we have to take antibiotics. And third asset is a lifestyle. Yes, that's very important. Lifestyle means you have to completely change the way you are living. Means you have to take a good, healthy, nutritious diet. You have to take 8 hours sleep. You have to do regular exercise. So lifestyle is very, very important. Stay healthy, eat healthy, exercise, 8 hours sleep, and remain hydrated. In Indian Council of Medical Research, ICMR, they have given a chart of RDA, that is recommended daily allowances. They say that you go and take this much of calories, you take this much of fat, you take this much of protein. This is okay, this is recommended. But to boost our immunity, we have to take extra of all these things, such as protein. Any kind of protein you can go for, like whey protein is good, casein, animal protein is also good, soya protein is also good. Because to boost immunity, the protein has multifaceted role. It modulates the whole immune system. It is antimicrobial. It has a anti-inflammatory action. It is antioxidant. It has that antioxidant capacity. So protein is very good. But it is seen in that the Indian people usually don't go for protein. It is lacking in their platter. So here at this platform, I would suggest each and every people, even I have included, now I'm focusing more on diet. So what I'm doing, I'm trying to include a protein in my diet daily. Secondly, if the protein lays the foundation of the immune system, then I would say that micronutrients, means multi-minerals and multivitamins, have to be added in our diet. They form the pillar of the immunity. So protein lays the foundation, and the pillars are made up of multivitamins and multi-minerals. So all these things are needed to boost the immunity. I would say that pregnancy itself comes under high risk category. There is as such no evidence to suggest that during pregnancy, pregnant women will be severely ill. But yes, they are included in a group of moderate risk people. So they have to be very careful during this pandemic era. Every woman must need a strong immune system. In a well-nourished body, in terms of nutrition, or we can say that the nutrients what we take to boost our immunity. If a body which is well-nourished, even if it comes in contact with the disease will not manifest. So at this time, it becomes really important for pregnant women to nourish their body. And a body which is well-nourished is what? It's our body is 100% nutrition. So at this point in this pandemic era, it becomes very important for every pregnant woman to focus on her diet and her nutrition. Yes, ICMR as such has given us a chart what pregnant women should have. But to detail over here, I would say, talk about the protein, then 55 gram of protein is sufficient for a normal woman. But here the pregnant woman would need 55 plus 23 gram of protein per day, that I'm saying. And if I say that she should go for a 25 milligram of fat, then here I would need to give her 30 gram of protein per day. And the same way, she should include in her diet the DHA. DHA is helpful for development of eyes of the babies. The brain development, it is very much important. She should include in her diet the probiotic. Probiotic is a substance that protects the normal gut flora, intestinal flora. So it boosts the normal good bacteria. We have in our intestine the bad bacteria as well as good bacteria. What the good bacteria do? They engulf whenever any bad particle or any virus or bacteria enters into the intestine. They engulf that bacteria and they don't let the bacteria enter into the blood circulation. Besides this, they release the constipation. Besides this, they don't let the pregnant woman get indigestion, constipation. So these are important. Besides this, they should include fibers, multivitamin, multiminerals. If she is taking, a normal woman needs 600 milligram of calcium per day, here I will give 1200 milligram of calcium per day. So in this way, they have to change their nutrients, what they communicating before pregnancy. Every pregnant woman worried. And I would say, yes, pregnant women can transfer the infection to their babies. In editorial publication by the American Journal of Perinatology, it is clearly stated that a pregnant woman can transfer COVID infection through her placenta to her baby by three mechanisms. Number one, vertical transmission, means what I said, through the placenta to the baby. And if the mother is severely infected during last trimester, then baby will get active infection of this COVID. And thirdly, after this is during delivery, the second one, if she is very severely infected during her last trimester, then baby will get infection during delivery. And even after delivery, if the caretakers of the baby or who the persons who are handling the baby are infected with the COVID-19, then yes, the baby is very sure that will get the infection. To every pregnant woman, being gynecologist, I would say that remain hydrated, go for a balanced diet, take proper 8-hour sleep. When I say that, take 8 to 9 hours sleep during night and 2 hours sleep during daytime, you should go for. And if possible, and if your gynec is suggesting, few exercise can be allowed if she doesn't come under high risk category. And then she should follow all the instruction to prevent infection, like wearing mask, repeated hand washing, and social distancing. Third, remain happy and always think positive, and take all the supplements which has been suggested by your gynecologist. Take the complete treatment if it is given. Don't miss anything and try to avoid the people who are suspected of having the COVID infection. That is my saying today.